In this video, I'm gonna be sharing 4 tips that I wish I knew when I learned to foil board. Now, full disclosure, I'm just an average kiter. I'm not an expert foil boarder. So if that's what you're looking for, this isn't the video for you. But if you're interested in learning foil boarding, then I think these tips will be useful. Full disclosure, I still love to twin tip and I do so on higher wind days. But for me, foil boarding is great for those light wind days when otherwise I'd be sitting on the beach or mowing the lawn. Foil boarding is a great way to progress and add new challenges on those lighter wind days. So let's dive into those 4 tips. Tip number 1, don't break the bank on your first foil board, especially if you're not so sure foiling is even for you. Now, I lucked out and I got a great deal on my first foil board. However, if I were in the market right now looking for my first foil board, I would definitely be looking either at entry-level boards or used boards. And the reason being is because I pretty much destroyed my first foil board, or at least the front wing, by hitting underwater rocks. I ended up cracking my first wing. I was able to repair it and I was able to resell it at a reasonable price. Tip number 2 would be to try with a big wing like this one at first, but then don't be afraid to try smaller wings after you're up and foiling. I was on the big wing for quite a while before I started transitioning to the medium wing, but once I did, I really began to enjoy foiling much more. I was going a lot faster and doing things like jumps and back rolls became much easier. And now I'm actually looking forward to trying out race wings. Tip number 3 is to work on your balance. The beauty of this is you can do it on no wind days or days like today when there's just not enough wind. Personally, I found this incredibly useful for things like transitions on a foil board. Previously, we made our own balance board pretty inexpensively, and you can check that video out here. However, since then, we've upgraded to the skill board, which has been fantastic because not only do you get to practice side-to-side balance, but also front-to-back. This board is great too because you can adjust the difficulty by either inflating or deflating this ball. If you're interested in checking out the skill board, make sure to check out the link in the description below. Tip number 4 is to experiment with different kite types and different kite sizes. I think it's pretty common for most people to learn on large kites when learning to foil, and I was definitely guilty of this myself, often going for 12 or 15 meter kites. However, I do think it did start to stall my progression as I became a little bit too reliant on the lift of the kite rather than foiling itself. Now my favorite kites for foiling are actually quite small. So I personally really enjoy foiling on the Sol 2 8-meter and the Sonic 3 9-meter. Those are my go-to. However, I wouldn't know that if I didn't experiment with different kites. Of course, your mileage will likely vary. And if you don't try different kites and different wing sizes and different combos, you really won't know what works best for you. So don't be afraid of ditching the kite that you learned to foil with for something else that's fresh and new to see what works best. It is worth noting that while the 8-meter and the 9-meter kites are my favorite for foiling, most commonly I'm probably on the 10-meter sole, just given the light wind conditions that we have here in Ontario. In fact, I'd say 10-meter sole is probably one of the most common kites we see for foiling on our local beach. All right, I'm gonna throw in one extra bonus tip, and that is just to bring your foil board to the beach. So many times we came to the beach without a foil board, expecting a great twin tip session, only to be sitting there thinking, I could have been foiling right now. It's definitely worth it to lug it to the beach. Even if you have a long walk, throw it in your buggy and bring it, and you will get in so much more practice and you will progress so much faster that way. All right, guys, those are my tips for foiling. Hopefully you found them useful. Let me know if I've missed anything in the comments below. And as always, thank you so much for watching. We'll see you in the next one.